As you guys call, okay? Little bit?
No.
Okay. No more. Perfect. Little bit comfortable? You feel comfortable? You want to put some cushions here? You need to feel comfortable, no? And how are you?
Very well.
Good. Cut it.
Yeah. School $8.
Yeah. But you forgot here.
It's warm for winter.
Good. It's very cold.
No, very cold.
Exactly. All right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But if you think about many.
So therefore, it is difficult to achieve this human rebirth. And among the six realms of migratory beings, the human realm is considered as one of the higher realms.
And the current and the door to the alcohol was pena. More la la maya than the denosum, which now I had the denosum learning, denosum to the race.
So, as you know, the six realms, right? The three upper realms and three lower realms. Three lower realms are the hungry ghosts, the hell beings, and the animals. And the three upper realms are human, demigods, and gods.
And the Tanto Kagina, Tiwana, Kagitan, Kuala Tanjana, Tashitan, Taduma.
And so wherever you are born in this, in any of these three, six realms, of course you are within the nature of suffering. So humans, gods and demigods are the upper realms.
And
human beings may have the sufferings of birth, aging, sickness, death.
Right. So we
have lots of suffering of birth, which we have gone through already, right?
And
then suffering of sickness, you know, we fall sick, you know, all the time, right?
And
then suffering of aging, which is happening to us all the time.
Everybody doesn't want to go aging, right? But if no choice, they just continue day by, year by, month by, and in hours, then seconds, the moment, they all change. And the Marashika Nashi Dungas, and then Lamaya Tatsuk Dungas, so
those are the sufferings of human beings, and there's the suffering of constant fighting. with the demigods.
So
demigods are very jealous of the gods, and so therefore they are always fighting, you know, with the gods.
अनि ने देविन देखा था लामा ने कौन हिरो रचे मासो ना अनि ता लाल तुम्हें दे इंजो मेरे ना लाते लामा लासे दे तो शिकार शेरे पे काम करते हैं तुम्हें शेरे जंगल में से
and so usually the gods and unless they are troubled by the demigods they don't have any suffering so the only suffering they have is at the time of death that they see the sign of death and that is when they really suffer so much
अनि तीन दिन का तो कहने लगो समझ ना ने नमला अनि सुपोला या ट्रेशन में जो शुम कवच अनि सुपोला ट्रेय वच अनि लातो लम्बो कमासो लो कवाय मच अनि शिटो वच लो करा सुस लिंग जिया पे नी बाचो अनि लिला या चमा तो जटो लो अनि लादा लम्बो सुस ची सुस लो चरो मार वच इन दुमा अनि शिवा लगा अनि सुसो कवच के रे हो अनि सुसो मंगो रे
so the suffering, you know, they have at the time of death, you know, so when they're about to die, usually they have all the things on their body, the clothes, you know, the fragrances, you know, and the ornaments, and everything is so fresh, and they don't have to change or wash anything, you know, it stays fresh all the time. And so they're like the flower garlands, you know, and so forth. So when the time of death comes, then all these things, you know, become old, you know, their body starts to smell, and the flower garlands, you know, starts to wither. And then the other gods, you know, who are always, you know, playing with them, you know, surrounded to them, now, you know, kind of run away, you know, because they start to smell. So the other gods, you know, run away, and then, you know, so they feel lonely and so forth. And then also they when they're more closer to death, and then at that time they see the next rebirth, you know, where they're going to be born. And then especially, you know, when they see that they're going to be born in the hell realm and so forth, and they suffer, they worry and suffer so much at that time.
Tenida tenro sang na na ya ta mi le sa de ta chaman bo gai bar so
in terms of you know dharma practice, you know, among these three higher realms or upper realms in human in the realm is considered the best
and pe na lai na ka na le ta ka ni vi na ka la le lai de wa la cha ni ka se ta gyo de de la ko ka me ne sa sa de gyo wa de la mo se ne ni te gyo to no ge des
so when you are born as gods during the whole life, the entire lifetime, one is always so happy, you know, so that one forgets that, you know, one is in cycle existence, or one is going to suffer, or one's going to die, and so forth. But I think about that, so always enjoying the happiness that they have there, and then, you know, the happiness that they experience is the result of the virtuous action. So as more happiness they enjoy, more virtuous, you know, the virtues they kind of use up, you know, consume. And so whatever the virtues they have created, they used it up, you know, by enjoying so much in that lifetime.
Oh, ta nanzo mil che wa yimai na. Ani ta ani na she kam tu de ma se de. Ta cha gi. Ka na ge wa tu na tu tu ni. Ani ji se ta wa ge wa sha ma wa. Wa ta sa ji ko ma se tu ba so so tu ba na tu tu ni ni ba. Ta na yo yi ba re se.
So if one is born as human being, especially born from womb, you know, with the or six elements, then, you know, in terms of practicing dharma, it's the best, you know, basis to, you know, to practice dharma. It has all the favorable conditions, and then also has the potential to achieve enlightenment in that very lifetime, you know, if one, you know, does practice dharma.
Tehi nani mi lege, nani chan, ani, oh, dharma jin jo vachya sami mi lege, ta tele jan nika, ta karika uimba desi.
So generally, just to be born as human being is very difficult, and especially to be born as human being with all these 8 pleasures and 10 endowments, it's even more difficult. So as you know, most of you have already heard Lamrim teaching so many times, you know all those examples, right? The examples that they illustrate, you know, to show how difficult it is to achieve perfect rebirth. So that, you know, because the reason why it is difficult, you know, to achieve this kind of perfect rebirth, you know, is because you have to create a very good cause, you know, to be born as a human being with all these favorable conditions to practice dharma, and so the main cause, you know, is absorbing the moralities of abandonment, tenant, virtuous action, and on top of that, and having assisted by the practice of the six perfections, and then also, you know, conjoined, you know, by the standless prayers, you know, to be born as a human being and so forth. So you have to have all these causes together in order to achieve this perfect universe. So because it is so difficult to create these causes, therefore it's difficult, you know, to be born as a human being with all these favorable conditions.
So,
how much, you know, how much difficult it is, you know, to clear the cause, that much rare the result is going to be, right?
Right. And I don't know how to say. For example, maybe jewelries, diamonds, maybe diamond rings, we can say. Diamond rings very rare, right? Because the diamond very,
So because it's very difficult to acquire the diamond, right? And so because it is difficult to acquire the diamond, it's rare, you know, to have diamond
jewelries.
You know, because, you know, we have, you know, had these prayers, and the stainless prayers, and, you know, assisted by the practice of the six perfections, you know, and with the observing of moralities, and so forth, so therefore we have achieved this perfect maneuver now. So assisted by the practice of the six perfections, means that you have to engage in the practice of six perfections. So right now we can see how much we are engaging in those practices.
You can see ourselves, right? That gives us a
And so when we say stainless prayer, the stain, you know, is the stain of the attachment, you know, to this life, or clinging to this life, you know. So that is the stain. So when I say stainless, means the prayer that is not, you know, that is free of clinging to this life.
We always do something clinging to say, oh, I want a very successful life. Everything is good.
So if you think like that, then that becomes clinging to this life.
But we most to that, right?
And so because it is difficult to clear that kind of cause, therefore it is difficult to achieve the prophet and rebirth. So that's why Lama comments, the Kadamba masters, and he used to say that, you know, the previous lives, you know, holy monk granted this, you know, perfect mandripa, and then the holy monk of this life, you know, don't, you know, grant, you know, a cliff, you know, of the down or a lower realm in the future. So we can tell, you know, what we were like in the previous lives by looking at this body, and then we can tell what we're going to be in the future by looking at our mind. And so even in this life, you know, some people are short, some people are tall, some people are ugly, some people are, you know, handsome and so forth. And so this is all, you know, this all depends, you know, on the kind of cause that one has created in the previous lives.
So if
we are, you know, just creating, you know, copy of some image, you know? And then you know you can you know or print you know of some sculpture, and you know whatever the masterpiece you have, you can just fill the substance you know with into that piece, and then whatever comes out of there will be exactly the same. And every time you put you know, print something, it will be exactly the same.
And then the pamachiki pula ya, and it pamachiki no there the pula susu kiwa mamma the palace of the rally, but the new general so he late jinji, get out of some powers.
So, just like example, also like a same parent you know, having a different children, a very different children, you know, shows that what kind of karma or an action that you, that they have that each of them you know, have created in their previous lives.
What in the is that jinji rapado some time, not to teach he told mother that he don't like him. And it's you, little uncle, not on to us.
And so if we think about a growth of, you know, cause and effects, then you know we can see the growths and all the fruits and so forth, right?
Well, Jinji said the any Japan is not another pattern of the not over this.
So if you think about the cause you know, and effect, you know, first you think of you should think you know, about the growth and cause and effect, and then you will be able to understand the subtle and subtle cause and effects.
So
for example, I'm now 43 years old, you know, I didn't become 43 overnight, right? I became, you know, 43 slowly, you know, with many, many years, many months, many weeks, many days, and so forth.
But when I got to reach the 30, it's very fast.
Yeah, I agree.
Right? Also, when I reach the 20, it's fast. Before 20, very hard to grow up. You know, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a little bit bigger. You know, I want to go to the adult people that but it's too much tech time, you know, the teenager place. Then we reach the 20, it's very fast. Then 30, oh, now 40. Now, you know, it's very fast. But this fast is also not just come to one day. Day by day, year by year. You know, just... Then that thing, how much is it? Shumate. That's just the number of things all about the problem. How much is it? Shumate more.
So the earlier time, disintegrates, and then you know, then comes the later time, or you can say the earlier time disintegrated, and that transformed into the later time.
Then the age in the summer time, then you know, that jela yanchi, nilen jela, nchi chi chi, niyong wele. The age in summer time, you know, ane chi, nilen ke pina, tiri ngay supon sose ke, nilen ke jete kasa ngay supon yu bachi. Tiri ngay soya, nchi chi chi, da kara dan, duplo dan, so, that's so yu was.
That also then for the cause there is like the substantial cause and then the auxiliary cause and so forth. Right? So the substantial cause is the cause that transforms into the entity you know, of the result. Like for example, today's body, the substantial cause of today's body is yesterday's body. Yesterday's body became today's body. Right? So yesterday's body, you can say, is the substantial cause you know, of today's body. But whereas the auxiliary you know, cause you know, will be like the food, you know, the clothing, you know, whatever other things that supported my body you know, to be alive today. You know, it's all are all you know, auxiliary cause.
And then how do you deal with Shima Yuzhala? They are two different causes, right?
So we believe in past and future lives, you know, so that you know, is also you know, proved in that way. So will you be able to prove that there is a past and future lives?
So if you just
say this is what Buddha said, then that's not a correct reason.
So
of course the Buddha has said it, but on top of that you can also use logical reasoning. So if it doesn't contradict with the logical reasoning, then it's really true.
대대인바다다테라난도지시다시바다마세인도와스가시바도와스.
So we have this mind or consciousness, right?
아니 시편 예능이 제가 시바 코너들인데 봐 시바 마토원이 뱀보 시부년한테 제요 말했어.
And so the substantial cause, you know, of that mind can be only the mind, you know, the matter, you know, cannot serve as a substantial cause for mind.
그러나 쪽 예능이 제가 쪽 코너들인데 봐 마토 신기 쪽 예능이 제요 말했어.
And so, for example, the substantial cause of the iron, you know, can only be iron, right? You know, a wood cannot become a substantial cause, you know, of the iron.
예능이 이제 써야 돼. 다 저부터야 모은 분노, 모은 이제 나고 싶다 그래서.
So the substantial cause is something that, you know, transforms, you know, into the entity of the result.
대리가 만족했다. 싶어서가 남는데. 대리 예능이 이제 계속 싶어 돼 말해서.
So today's mind, you know, the substantial cause of today's mind, you know, is yesterday's mind.
그래서 가슴 시바대 되는 게 시부대 뭐 봐. 죄송하러 왔어.
So yesterday's consciousness changed into the entity of today's consciousness.
다 되시면 다 되는 시바대 가왔나? 다 가슴 시바대 되시 말해서 뭐라 그랬어.
And so where did this come from? What is this mind of today, you know, came from? And it came from yesterday's mind. So it is the is the later continuum, you know, of yesterday's mind.
다들 봐봤는데 다 먼저 we are all adults, right? I mean teenagers, then the kindergarten, and then 보고 다 아니 이제 되는 데다 보고 여자 아니면 조교 같은 시바지에서 처음 온다 먼저 친지 용되게 됐어.
So it's the continuation of the mind stream, you know, of the infant, and then goes back, you know, into the child in the womb, and then goes back, you know, like that, all the way back, you know, to the previous life.
아니 다 된지가 아니 가세네. 아니 아메 조건이고 다 보고 주주 되게 샘도 가봐야 하겠나. 아니 샘데다 밤만 여고 잡아라 지금 내 가서 아니 아니 샘지 좀 봐. 저 남마디 봐도 봐도 다 되는 줄로 그래서.
And so it is the, you know, the consciousness, you know, of that baby, you know, who was conceived, right? And so, you know, at the time of the father and mother's copulation, and that consciousness enters, you know, into the, you know, the womb of the mother. Yeah, so and so that consciousness came from the previous life.
다 가지 테레비 시간 때는 라고 말이 가지 나오지 나오겠다 되는데 되는다고 나고 이랬어.
So it is a little bit different, you know, from the way the scientists, you know, or science, you know, will explain. You know, that's, but this is how, you know, Buddhism explains, you know, that how the mind, you know, enters into the womb.
너 가지 맞이 밤만 이게 되니까 이제 냠도 줘라 줘 삼아라 근데 대라 남시 대 맞이 간다 다 주는 거 이제.
So when the, you know, the sperm and egg, you know, meets together at that time, and the consciousness enters into the womb, you know, or the body of the mother. And so it is, you know, the consciousness of the being who was in the intermediate state, right? And after the before the birth, intermediate state. And so that mind, you know, of the the intermediate being, you know, came from the mind, you know, of the being in previous life.
뭐라고? 들리다다. 고치와 한번 봤다다 로서 왔나도 상당하나. 근데 신산지에 상당한 주로 시험도.
So that way we can trace, you know, the mind backwards, you know, to the previous life, right?
아니 다음에 가서 부모들 집다 집발했어. 아니 밤만 그죠. 밤만 그렇다요. 코나가 밤에 그죠. 대 밤에 그죠. 밤을 또 도망가도 자도 말해서.
And so same with the body, you know, of the person, right? So the body of the person came from the sperm and egg of the parents, and then that body, you know, came from the sperm and egg of the grandparents, and then great grandparents. So, you know, if you go back like that, you will not find the beginning.
ta deji chelo ma deji ma chelo chen tong do yero o tne do chen da ma to ka che jo ma che jo ma ma yo wa se du ji ga zhen ta du shi le shi wa.
So that's how we prove the existence, you know, of the previous lives.
So ma che san ji ge song chen la na and the san ji ge song ke me ne ji la ma to ta jo ma ma zhe le ta ko pen to yo ma le shi wa.
So you just say, oh, it's Buddha said it, then somebody who doesn't believe in Buddha, you would not be able to prove to that person.
So that if you check it, then you can't do that. Because you can't see what it is, but it's not the same.
So it is not really necessary, you know, to prove, but that is how, you know, it is in the fact, right? And you know, it's knowing that, you know, is helpful.
What do you think? Does it make sense?
So Geshe-la, for me, that explanation makes perfect sense for proving past and future lives. But what logic would we use to prove to people who believe that the mind and the brain are the same thing? How would we? What logic would we use to prove to them that the consciousness and the brain are not the same?
So first you ask the person, how do you identify the mind, how do you identify the brain? So how do you define the brain? I mean, so brain, right? So the brain is, you know, is a physical thing inside your head, right? So what do you call it? Is it a flesh or is it a, what is it? Something like a physical thing inside your, you know, inside your head, inside your skull. It's called brain, right? That's brain. But how do you define the mind?
Well, some people, they think that the mind is like what constitutes consciousness. Some people think that in the brain, like the chemical reactions responding to electricity, that kind of, like they can point to certain parts of the brain that they think, like the most active part, they think that's consciousness. Because that's what, you know, scientists can point to certain parts of the brain that are most related with, you know, different experiences of consciousness. So that's the most trouble I have with people when I have this discussion, is separating, like trying to prove how the consciousness is not the same as the brain. So like sometime, you know, when the brain is completely dead, but you know the body is still warm, and then how do you explain about that? You know, so if the brain is the mind, you know, then when it's completely dead, how can you have the body still warm? And so you know, the Buddhism explains that, you know, there's the subtle mind, you know, which is still inside the body that keeps the body warm and so forth. So I think I remember, you know, His Holiness mentioning that this is how you can prove that, you know, the brain is not mind. Is the body still as warm, like when somebody's in a coma, or?
다 타워 타자 되는 거 같이 이거는 내도 이제 타워 되는 거 같이 다 쉬는 소방을 잡을 거 같아.
So not warm like you know the for us the active you know fit, you know the alive body but like not like you know, cold like completely dead.
근데 전에 지금 합다친 게 삼십 년 내리는 거 보여서.
So some people live like that you know for many weeks.
대기도 안 가서 나비에다 시바 실로카다 내가 내가 지금 말해 시 시바로 막 가서 내가 다 시바 차고 차고씩 가지 또 봉보선 때리고 그랬어 된다고 내가 이거 봤는데 시에서 때리고 그랬어라고 시에다
So there's no function of the external body at all, but it is kept alive, you know, by the external. I mean the internal subtle mind. That's how it is explained in Buddhism.
나 들으러 간지 싸놓은 다 마음보지 간지 투지 땅으로 다 이제 와서 공부하고 그래 다 세지 않게 말하고 간지 싸놓은 다 수대야 하는 수대 조금 대사 단단히 대사 먼저 다 뒷골이야 이번에는 뭐 제일 오래 했어
So you can think in many different ways like that and of course there is there can be differences and it's not to like create any kind of arguments you know, or debates but of course it's good you know, to know in different ways about it
오다 타는데 들으러 다네 내려 내려지는 가지 따지와 마시대 진리대 투신대 가지 로 열에 들어와.
And so that's how anyway is you know proves and about the past and future lives, you know, future lives like in terms of the cause and effect and so forth.
근데 대라야 제와 마시대 봐라 이집에지 그 가지 대가 내버도 시바디 지게 말이나야 제와 마시 또 죽으러 가지.
So even if the brain and mind are same, you can still prove the previous lives, right?
근데 레바드 가운데
right?
예, 레바드 가운데 되는 바드 좋다 되고 희박해면 레바드 거기 희발 나와야 되고 경험을 더 좋으려 가서
so even if you are in the consciousness you know, apart from the brain and still if, even if you believe the brain is you know, the mind or consciousness and still you can prove that prove the previous life from that right so you can say where did this brain come from
되게 대체 대체 너무 안 돼. 참고 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 받았나? 생각 통한 얘기 말해.
And so if you keep on thinking, you know, the substance you know, of that brain, you know, where it came from and from which and then you will not find the beginning of that brain.
근데 다 시발라파 시발라파 있어야 돼. 간지 제와 가지 예매도 들어가고 가지 내가 그 말에 간지 다 시발라파 얘도 많이 듣고 이렇게 해야 돼. 그 제와 가지한테 좀 맡아봐도 제와 가지
So there is no harm in proving the existence of previous or past life from believing that brain you know, to be a mind and so forth. But of course, there is always you know argument about the you know, mind and brain you know being one or different.
And then after 시간나 다 그래 나서 대열에서 간나 사무다 달라가서 가는 데 모습도 보았어 나 대열에서 나고 그래. 대리받은 낙고 이런 게 꺼내서 있냐 하고 나왔어요
가을은?
가을은 모래에서 내봐놔 제대로 나 먼저 쌍둥이 낙하던 꼬리도 없어 근데 꺼내서 있냐
So scientists, they said the eye is here in the brain, is it?
Did they say this?
The eye
Some eye,
yes
Is
the eye here or eye? I'm eating?
Yes, I'm eating here
I'm eating.
I'm eating.
Scientists say that, huh?
I'm eating here, but I don't know.
So you point, when you say I, you point here?
No,
you point here.
Where do I point?
Yeah.
Where do the scientists point?
Both. Where do scientists point and where do you point?
I point here.
Yeah.
He is a scientist.
Scientists point here?
Not always.
Yeah, no.
Not always?
No. Sometimes they'll say me.
Yeah.
Sometimes they'll say, but I think I'm here.
Yeah.
I think it's
in the yeah, this, yeah, this. Mm-hmm. I heard that, you know, I don't know this truth. I don't know. What we point? We say, I'm here. Mm-hmm. You know, this is not me, right? It's also wrong. We say, I'm here. This is wrong, right? I pointed my chest. This is not me. Inside, you know, lungs. Or is it lower? Heart. This is not me, right? 그런데 산책이 아니 봉봉하려 때는 따로 잠을 해서 맞아요.
So, you know, of course, according to Buddhism, the I is a mere label, right? Label, you know, that's imputed on the five aggregates. So it's a mere level because you will not find it if you look for it. Because you cannot find it if you look for it, therefore it's called mere level.
Don't make this up. Isn't there? I don't embarrass myself with the question. Isn't there a drop immediately above the heart that represents? I don't know how I'm going to write the mind. Or isn't there a drop and death it dissolves? I'm way over my head.
Yeah.
Way over my head. But that's why I sort of said, you know, I'm here. That's
good. Yeah, 아주 그 니가 길었던 틀레비 좋았어. 그럼 미시베 틀레.
나.
그 틀레 가만히. 미시베 틀레 가만히 되지 나였어. 되나는데 남시 담아 되었어. 근데 남시 담아 된 거는 나한테 있겠다. 안 되면 좋다. 캐릭이 내려요.
맞아요.
그래서 그때 내가 대지를 왔어.
대지에 가시 왔어. 가시에 남시 만대게.
아니. 내 남시 때 여사를 때 맞아. 니가 나와서 그러. 니가 나 이럴 수가 없다. 미시가 틀려나봐.
나한테 짜가 나라 이럴 수가 없다고
해놓았어. 대체 대회에서 대라 대체 맞아 나와서 대주고를.
대오판 지금 로나 대가오 맞아 얘네가 말해서. 그지 대나 롱근로 도시가 따네 롱근로 도시가 따는 것도 따고 해놓았어.
나 대단 맞아 맞아 또 그저 대단하다 나 원래 그 캘린게 대서
일단 이럴 수가 없다. 그 대미 올라.
네 그저 근데 대단 얘기 그랬어 그럼 어떠?
예지 나시 가 대신 동일 해놓았어. 어떠죠 대대 그래. 나한테 내 캐내기 그래서. 이지 남시 받으래서
Yeah, so when we talk about different schools, you know, of thought or tenets, and then there is a different explanation about that. So some tenet, you know, believe that there is a I existing from its own side, and so it is the person who go by the middle school who doesn't believe and who doesn't assert in the I or anything else, and anything existing from its own side. And so the other schools, they believe that, you know, you can find it. If you look for it, you can find it, and that is it. You know, so this is the I that you can find. So therefore, you know, you can point and say this is I. And so and they believe that the subtle consciousness, so which we say, you know, we have this the chakra or central channel, inside the central channel at the heart, at the level of heart, there is this the indestructible drop. Yeah, and then inside the indestructible drop, you know, is the subtle consciousness, and that is the I, the illustration of I. So they would say that, you know. So for them, yes, that's true. So you can point that and see. But according to the Prasangika Madhyamika school, there's, you know, no I exists from its own side, and so it's a mere level, you know, level on the group of the five aggregates. So the different tenets, you know, will explain about the I, you know, the self or the I in different ways, you know. So they said this is the self or this is the I. And then, you know, according to the Prasangika Madhyamika, you know, there's no I exists from its own side, there's no I that you can point and say, oh, this is the I, you know. So it's a mere level, you know, imputed by your mind. And so if you look for it, you will not find it.
어디 다들 다 나도 강사서 가지 미세하대. 근데 제가 다 나도
So anyway, we went back to the prophet of Indrubarth, where we came from. So anyway, if we have the prophet of Indrubarth, then we have all the favorable conditions to practice Dharma, and through that, you know, we can achieve all the higher state of, you know, rebirth, the liberation from cycle existence, or even up to like a complete enlightenment of Buddhahood. And then the three lower realms, like the hell realm, hungry ghost realm, and the animal realm. And so those are the six realms,
six realm beings.
The animals are, you know, like the birds, the, and the animals that we see outside.
And the hungry ghost beings,
you know, who are not able to find any food and food and drink, and who die of starvation or famine and so forth, and that's called the hungry ghost. And then the hell beings, you know, there are many different types, the hot hell, cold hell, and the neighboring hells, and so forth. And so, don't have to talk too much about it. Now let's go back to the text about the mind and mental factor. So beings, like human beings, you know, have a body and a mind. So the consciousness or the mind, you know, is the thing that cognizes, you know, the objects. And so that's the I know it, I recognize it, or I'm aware of it, and so forth. So that thing that, you know, makes one to be aware, to recognize, to know, and so forth, is called mind.
And then simply shiba peche tomala tene, yeti tan naman jene, tan lishi zonga tosong sa yung yung
yuros. And so by utilizing that mind, you know, which kind of, you know, characterizes that object, you know, by saying it's good, it's bad, and so forth, then through those mind, then we say, oh, I know it, you know, I recognize it, and so forth.
Then this shiba tala yang, wang xie de yip shiba nye yuris, right?
And then that kind of consciousness has like the sense consciousness and the mental consciousness,
So
the sense consciousness are the, like the eye consciousness, which sees the object, the ear consciousness, which hears the sound, nose consciousness, which smells, you know, the fragrance, and so forth. And so those are the sense consciousnesses.
And yeti shiba sayate, ta tiga chan yeti shiba sayate.
And the mental consciousness is produced, you know, led by those sense consciousnesses.
And wang xie de wo cha shaba yina. And wang bo la ya, zhuk te xia, te shaba la te ne, and wang xie de wo cha.
So for the sense, you know, consciousness, the organ, you know, the sense organ, the object appears, you know, to the sense organ, and then from there, then the sense organ, you know, then from there comes the sense consciousness. So then the object appears to the sense organ, and then sense consciousness, you know, cognizes the object. So, for example, like the sound, you know, when the sound is produced, you know, it has to meet, you know, the sound has to meet with the ear organ, right? The organ, and when it meets with the ear organ, and then, you know, then the ear consciousness is developed, you know, so the ear consciousness will hear the sound.
The second
And so how long does it take, you know, for the sound, you know, the sound, you know, to be heard by the ear consciousness? You know, how long does, from after the sound has been developed, and how long does it take, you know, the duration? The scientists, you know, they check that also.
Deni parachin ta kani cheso wa na ani rat ko ma ta ma che wa chi na nga do cheso ro chi der chi ko ngi sa ro so
the wave of the sound, you know, has to reach, you know, to the eye organ, I mean the ear organ, right? And so if it doesn't reach, you know, if it breaks in between them, the ear organ would not be able to hear that sound.
Ani am jo do mi ni gi nga so ta 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 ye ta ri ko ni ka do ko ye ta cha che do ro.
So the eye consciousness, the eye consciousness and the ear consciousness, you know, can perceive the object, you know, for, at a very distance, right?
And the teacher pasi nashi sare nashi ano tani mo shira ko mare kana pe so no ya ma ko toma de ko de to ko.
And then after that, the nose consciousness, you know, of course it you know, even if its object is far away, it can still smell. It can still smell your nose consciousness, right? And so you don't have to be so close.
And the jie the lishie said that I jie jie that you took over was.
And so for the tongue consciousness, you know, it has to be touched. Right? You have to, the tongue has to touch. And then of course for the body consciousness, you know, it has to develop that contact, you know, with the object.
Then the one thing I would say, talk about that then, that we have to lishie that that jie was the one which.
And so then, followed by those sense consciousness, you know, cognizing and cognization of the object, then there followed by that, then there comes the mental consciousness, you know, after each of these sense, five sense consciousnesses. And so, for example, the eye consciousness which sees the object, right, which sees a form, you know, that's the eye consciousness, that's right, the sense consciousness.
Та иди шибаре кардына та дана мазу соду на дене мазу на мазу чи сам шаг до вас о га на дене си о чи чи ё со тле тле ди шибаре ро.
And so right now you don't see, you're not at your home, but you can think about your home, right? Say, oh, my house is like this, it has this color, it has this shape and so forth. You can think about that, right? So that's the mental consciousness.
О тле ди шибаре ро. Ва ши ди те ди 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 тре ро ро. Та иди шибаре ко ме тре та тре ро.
So for the sense consciousness, it has to meet with the object, you know, at a closeness or at a distance, but it has to meet with the object. For the you know, the mental consciousness, you know, it doesn't have to meet, you know, with the object. And so then, you know, the consciousness can be divided into, you know, the sense consciousness and the mental consciousness like that. And also it can be divided into valid consciousness, you know, and invalid consciousness.
Amen, not that. Not valid, oh yeah, not this. Today is a time, Sema said, Kanji, that's Sada Tongi, Tambo Tongi, that's Sema, Sada Tongi, Mlawa Yimba, Shubai Yigata, Sema said.
So for the valid mind or valid consciousness, it has to be new, it has to be infallible, it has to be and then cognizing, right? So something that new, infallible, cognizing is called is the valid mind.
And the chudo tambo ga kati tambo thoi kala ta te tobelo te na hibelo te ta chema chale etro.
So for example, first time when you see me, that first time that mind, you know, sees me for the first time, you know, that becomes the valid mind. Then that it becomes the direct valid mind. So before you met me, you know, if somebody told you that the Gurukula Center there's an Geshe called like this and so forth, and you have some idea, right?
You're a fat, you're a short. Anyone kind of, just call now. Describe. Anyone describe the one Geshe short, little fat. No one said you got this. Because you tell about Tindi, if someone said that, then we have some messages. Oh, yeah. Tindi, you're some something with those. That they talk about the Jishma Chandra.
So that thought, you know, or idea about the person that you've been described, that's called a conceptual mind, you know, consciousness.
What is that? That's what I'm saying. 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 That's what I'm saying.
And so you saw me today, and then, you know, the mind that, you know, sees me tomorrow again, you know, is not seen for the first time, it's already stalled now, right? So that becomes the subsequent consciousness, consciousness.
And then that thing about Chenang, so Ching Nga Ching, Diwan Ruhi, Ota Tenjik, Numa Da Ma Rao Toa Ye Na, Aya, Te Toba Tsa Ma Sa Ba Tiya Ma Shung, Numa Te Na Jin Toa Na, Ta Chi Shi Sa Ni Ma Lo, Tsa Ma Sa Ta Ma Re Sa.
So if you are seeing the same person, you know, and seeing the same thing, then that is seeing the same thing again. Then it becomes the subsequent consciousness, subsequent mind. But if you are seeing the same person but in a different form, you know, like becoming a little bit older, or, you know, seeing a little bit different thing, then that you haven't seen before, right? Even though it's the same person, but you have seen the difference in that person, and so that difference, you know, is new, right? That difference is new, so that is a valid mind. And so the consciousness, you know, the sense consciousness sees it, and then the second moment, you know, followed by that, then there comes the mental consciousness. And so those are the valid mind, right? So then there's the mistaken mind as well. So the mistaken mind, is mistaken, of course, is by the word you understand that it's mistaken. It's like, you know, thinking of something which it is not, right? Thinking of something as such and such when it is not that. And so, for example, like, you know, when we're in the car, we think that, you know, the trees, you know, by the roadside are moving. You know, the trees are not moving, right? You know, but we think, you know, oh, trees are moving, because it's just because we are moving, it makes us feel like the trees are moving, but it's not. So that would be a mistake in mind.
Maybe you guys, maybe not just the organ driving, you doesn't see that. You have no time to see that as such. No, tell you, I think I'm going to move on to it.
And so, like, some people, you know, with the diseases, viral diseases, you know, sees, you know, things in different colors, right, yellow and so forth, right? And then some people, they say, like, you know, because of the different lens in your world, you think you see this white mountain as a blue, you know, like blue lens, you see the blue, so then you think, oh, it's a blue, so thinking that, you know, and then, sometimes when you see, like, you know, you rub your eye and then look at the moon, you know, you see the two moons. You think, oh, that looks like there's two moons, but that's also mistaken, right? And then also, of course, you know, grasping at the true existence, you know, thinking that the things exist from their own side without depending on, you know, other things, is a mistaken mind. So then there's, you know, the consciousness can be divided as two, like, you know, the consciousness, the sense consciousness and mental consciousness, or a valid consciousness and invalid consciousness, and so forth.
And so then there's,
So anyway, we've gone through that already before, so we'll have to go through that again. The mind has this, the consciousness has that mind and mental factors.
And the same said,
So the mind, you know, is called mind because of, you know, cognizing just the entity, you know, of the object. And so by, you know, distinguishing or differentiating the object, it's called, you know, the mental factor. So generally the mind and mental factor are there all the time together, you know, they're all the time together, but we don't think in that way, you know. So it's, unless you know about it, or have thought about it, you know, you will not know, you know, what is mind and what is mental factor. It all seems like one. So, for example, the mind, you know, which, you know, just like for example, seeing the table, you know, sees the table and says, you know, that's the main mind, the mind. And then they says that which sees the all. A beautiful table, or ugly table, or, you know, big table, or small table, you know, that is the mental factor.
Okay.
And so the mental, so the main mind, you know, just is one, you know, but, you know, then, but there are, you know, 51 mental factors, you know, around that one mind, the main mind. And so there are some, you know, which are good and some which are not good. So the 5 omnipresent mental factors and 5, you know, the accidental object mental factors are needed all the time. So if any of these are missing, then the mind will not be able to perform the function. So what are the 5 omnipresent mental factors? Omnipresent mental factors are like the feeling, right?
Discrimination, attention.
So if we don't have the feeling, we'll not be able to experience, right? Experience good or bad things, right? So because we have the feeling, therefore we are able to experience, you know, the sufferings and happinesses, right? So if there is no discrimination, so we'll not be able to, you know, discriminate, right? So we'll not be able to say this is good, this is bad, and so forth. And it says if you know, if the intention is not there, then the mind will not be able to, you know, engage in the object. So it is the intention, you know, that makes the mind, you know, to engage in the object. It's like you know, the magnet, you know, that pulls the object towards it. So it's the intention that pulls, you know, the mind, you know, towards the object. So engages the mind in the object. And then the attention is the one that, you know, focuses on a particular object. And so if that is not there, then we'll not be able to, you know, focus on a particular object.
And then repasati ta tsuade.
And then if there's no contact, the contact, you know, is the is like the support, you know, for the feeling, so that, you know, enables the feelings to rise, right? So for example, like if your mind, you know, a man mind is, you know, observing or recognizing an object, which of these 5 will come first? main mind is observing an object. You know, like say for instance, your main mind is looking at the table, right? Which one will come first? Which of these five omnipresent mental factors will come first?
They all have to be there.
They all have to be there. They're all together.
It's in the definition of omnipresent.
I'm cheating by saying that. Then
So, Jesus said he thinks that, you know, the first comes the intention, right? Engaging in the object. You know, so you look at the table, right, for example. You know, and then from there comes the attention, right? And then from there comes the discrimination. And then from there comes the contact. And then comes the feeling. So feeling seems to come the last.
I don't know.
About something that happened on the side, I have no intention to... Something that happened on outside the door here, I have no intention to pay attention to it, but let's say there's an explosion or something. I get my... Here, consciousness will get the contact first to get my attention, to get all the rest that goes with it. Mm-hmm. So if I did not have the intention to hear, but I got the contact, so I don't know about which one would come first on that with the attention.
Now you guys are checking. just check into the kitchen. I don't know also either which one comes.
It's a good question though.
Also chest, I didn't see that chest also getting clean, which one fast.
Yeah, so you can think about it.
Okay.
So after that are the five object as ten mental factors,
right?
So, five object as ten mental factors are aspiration, belief, mindfulness, meditation, stabilization, and wisdom, right? And so, like the first, the aspiration, you know, the aspiration is there. So, these all go together all the time. So the aspiration, you know, is the mind, you know, that wishes for it, right? Wishes to be endowed, you know, wishes to have it, right? So that's called the aspiration. And then the belief, you know, is whatever you have aspired, thinking that that's what it is, you know, is belief, right? And the mindfulness is the one, you know, then, you know, the one that does not allow it to be forgotten. And then the meditative stabilization, you know, is whatever you have remembered, you know, just focusing on that and not being distracted from that, you know, is the meditative stabilization. And so then the wisdom, you know, is the one that analyzes, you know, the object. So the object that is remembered or that is focused on, you know, so analyzing on that.
And
so which of these will come first? You know, I think it's the aspiration, right? And so the aspiration, you know, is the main cause, you know, for generating effort. So what is the aspiration? Can you give an example of aspiration?
나도 가디나 알 수 있지. 빼자도 맞다 같이 수지. 삼수지. 넘버 세대다 되는 얘기로 해. 되는 얘기로.
So the aspiration in is the mind that wishes for something, right?
그래서 딴 조조치야. 다시 무슨 말이야?
Can you give an example?
Be happy not to suffer.
딱 대화 되는 얘기로 그러. 되지?
대화 들어.
딱 대화 높이기 로드시. 대화 더 능이 로지 용도 와서 딱 대화 넘버 하
You
are the most
wishes for happiness, right?
Mm.
Yeah.
Well,
you always have that, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the mind wishes to go to more. It's aspiration.
Yeah. 넘버도 가야 돼. 그 야, 도대체 넘버가 뭐 이걸 돼? 안 지금지 넘버서 야, 도대체 넘버가 뭐지?
So the aspiration can be more good and bad, right? It's not necessarily one to two.
가래나 가래 돈은 이만한 돈은 이만한 돈 더 받지. 다 못 받아야 돼. 다 눈빛 강성 다 있는 사람들이지. 다 누가 니를라 못 받아야 돼. 아니 다 나도 남별이다. 아니 건조성 몇 점이 하나 인생하고 다 때 다 있는 사람들이거든 못 받아요.
And then the faith or belief, you know, the belief is the thing that whatever you have wished for, the thing is that that's what it is, right? You know? So like here it talks about the belief in three jewels, like Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, so that kind of belief.
And then I thought that maybe just mumble, 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 just that. I'm just thinking that I am telling you, kidding, just that. Telling you what?
So thinking that you know the three jewels, Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, and are the ultimate object of refuge, and thinking that that's really how it is, or thinking that is the truth, is the belief.
얘들 다 대꾸주는 거 맞지 그랬나? 아니 전부 다 너도 저 전부 하고 싶은 데 왔어.
And then you can have that mindfulness or the memory, the good memory of the three jewels, not forgetting the three jewels.
봐. 이거 뭐 전부. 다 띵이 되든 셈 파티. 이거 맞지. 이거 맞지. 다 너도 셈 다 가는 거 뭐 띵이 뭐 약간.
And concentration or meditative stabilization is the mind that you know doesn't allow allow the mind to be distracted here and there, rather you know, focuses on objects single pointedly. And then the analyzing the wisdom, you know, is the one that analyzes, right? The checks. So you guys are fond of checking, right? You should have good wisdom.
나도
So if one any of these you know five ascertained objects you know object ascertained manufacturer is missing, then the mind will not be able to perform function.
나한테 매대 다 미쳐가 봐. 뭔가든 매대 다 무시하고 강아지도 말했어.
So that person will not be able to perform you know, all the functions of the person. So that person will be just a half person.
그 아마도 잡아 때문에 온도 와.
So some people there are some people who don't have a stable mind, right?
그 가지에 온도 와.
And some people they don't feel much, and no matter how much you pinch or hit, the person doesn't feel that much.
그 play to that they all this one.
Boxing.
Yeah, this guy's much, they don't have much. No feeling. You want to hit. 다 쇼지는 고스 다 로드 걸어 대가 고스 장성을 와 있나 같이 다 들을 거라 상로 따네 소소 예레니에 그 딱가로 냐게서 그 남도 예레니에 소리 나가 지하지도 없어 바바 로드 그 가르카다 무슨 오레스
So maybe they have the feeling, but you know that's not the feeling is not that strong. Or maybe you know they're so used to that, you know, that punches and all the hits and that they don't feel that much, you know. Anyway, so you know, it's the same thing that we all have that kind of the mental factors, you know, the feelings and so forth. So it is same that you know we all, as human beings, you know, we all experience in our day-to-day life.
What? That guy? That is that. Then you watch it. You said you come out. You manage to pass.
Then after that, the 11 virtues, mental factors, right? So we have gone through that a little bit.
다 가더라도 담보 대화 대외 문답 대화 했다 냄비를 들어보시겠어 담보 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 담보
So the first of the 11 mental factors, 11 virtues mental factor are is the faith. The faith is the result of the aspiration.
And
then
there's
the differences between the faith, you know, the belief, faith and liking and respect. So is there differences or not? And so it says here, what is faith? It is a conviction. It is a conviction, clarity, and wishing with respect to true and existent that is endowed with excellent qualities and power. It has the function of acting as support for aspiration. Then when the faith is divided, there are three types, right? The clarifying faith, faith of conviction, and wishing faith. So the faith of conviction, the faith, clarifying faith is like the clear mind in general by seeing the excellent qualities of those so endowed, such as the three jewels.
And the Yeshi Tawas, that Jamie Sura, the legendary, the Yechewa. And the Tela Gawa, that's your gaining, which is the Tawas.
So it says the faith of conviction, you know, is the gaining of conviction through contemplating the modes, you know, of the dependent rising, cause, result, and so forth. So, like, you know, having faith, you know, in the scriptures or the teachings of the conquerors and so forth.
And the Yedichi Tawas.
So the wishing faith is, for instance, having contemplated the modes of the Four Noble Truths, ascertained the true suffering and true origin as object of abandonment, and the true cessation and true path as object of attainment, and having understood that, these can be attained if one makes the proper effort, the faith thinking, I shall definitely obtain them. So generally the faith, you know, is a conviction in the object, you know, that's the real, that's in the real object. And then have conviction towards that. It's called faith, right? So then they're talking about liking and faith, right? The liking, so liking, which is like the four possibilities, that which is liking but not faith. Example, like it says, liking one's you know, spouse and children, so that is a liking, but it's not in a faith. So because the reason why it's not like, not faith, is because it is attachment, right? Liking one's son or liking one's wife or husband, you know, is a liking, but it's not faith. And then the second, you know, the possibility of that, you know, which is faith but not liking, is that which is faith, no, but not liking is, for example, it says fear from one's depth, and the faith of conviction regarding the drawbacks of the sufferings of cycle existence.
我들은데
So for it to be faith, it doesn't have to be only positive, right? It can be towards the negative or towards you know, bad feeling. But as long as it is the real, it is real, then you know, you can have faith towards that. And so believing that there is only suffering in the cycle existence, you know, knowing, seeing that drawbacks, you know, of this cycle existence, because there's only suffering, so believing that, you know, that, you know, there's only suffering and there's no happiness, so there's no point to be attached to it and so forth, thinking like that, believing that there's only suffering, you know, in cycle existence. So that kind of faith, you know, that kind, that is a faith, but not a liking. Then there's a possibility of being both. Yeah, so that which is both faith and liking is, for example, the faith from one's death and the liking and the liking due to contemplating the excellent qualities of the spiritual guide and the benefits of wholesome actions and their results. So we'll stop here. There's not much to talk about it, but you know, if you have any questions, then you can ask questions.
Also, you guys also more interpretation is check.
So you yourself can check also on more on that.
I don't have much to say.
So I don't have anything more to say than what is already in the text. So the text, sometimes it makes sense, sometimes it doesn't make sense. So that would become, you know, that like thinking that, oh, there's only suffering in cycle existence and there's no happiness, and believing that there's only suffering, you know, in cycle existence. So that is a faith, right? You can say that's a faith of conviction.
Okay. Yeah. Go ahead. There's some question.
Keshela, in your opinion, do the five omnipresent mental factors arise at the same time or in the sequence?
According to his opinion, he mentioned it earlier, right?
That was what you said.
That was his, yeah.
Okay.
So he thinks the feeling is at the last. But Jeff thinks feeling comes first.
Contact.
So yes, so first comes the, I mean, compare, you know, when you compare these two, the contact and feeling, of course, contact comes first. Right? The contact comes first, and then comes the feeling. So before that, you definitely need the intention. Without the intention, you will not have the contact. And so the intention, you know, is the mind that engages, you know, the mind into the object, right? So even the sound that you're hearing, you know, if your mind doesn't you know, let your mind, you know, if your mind is not allowed, you know, to engage in that sound, you will not have that ear and that hearing, and you will not have the context, and then you will not have the feeling. Okay. So intention is the one that lets the mind engage in the object. You know. So therefore, intention is the first thing, I think.
Now we just talk about sound, okay? Tambo semba tege, ta jada do sami ba cha cha wachi. Tela te ne, ta ne de chi dare shan, ta ba chu dare shan, ta de shetan dare shan, ne ila shi ba te te ka ka wachi. Ta tela te ne, karo, so van dishi. Dishi ga, o ta ka cha wachi, ta ne da nyingbo du, ne da ya homan du spa chi. Tela te ne, repa chi wachi, repe go, ta repa ko, si cha pa no te shan, ta da de ya po shan.
So, for example, you know, when you talk about sound, you know, so then there's the intention is the one that allows the mind, you know, to engage, you know, to enter, you know, to engage into the sound, and then you know, from there comes the discrimination. It's just, you know, so, you know. Oh, this is a sound of a waterfall, or sound of a, you know, cow, or sound of a song, and so forth. You know, and then from there comes the contact. Yeah, so like, you know, and it says, "Oh, this is a nice song. This is a nice sound. This is a bad sound." That contact, and then from there comes, "Oh, it's a nice sound. So let's just get a feel good. This is a bad sound. You know, feel bad or unhappy, and so forth." So, and that's how I think it happens. So if it is something that you have to physically touch it or contact with it, then first, you know, comes the intention, and then comes the contact.
Exactly whatever that you guys check. go ahead.
Does contact have to have the sense organ involved? Or can we say if the mind makes contact with a mental object, there's no sense organ there, but there's still contact. So when we say contact, does it necessarily require a sense organ?
You don't need to have the sense consciousness. So here, this is the mind again, right? So here the context is the mind. It's not just the feelings of the touch and so forth. No? It's not that kind of context. It's the mind. So the mind that makes you to generate a feeling, you know, is called contact.
So the attention is like the steady focusing of the mind on its object? Attention?
Attention, yes. So yeah. Attention is the particular object, right? You know, so that focuses on a particular object of observation.
Usually, we all use this mind. That we don't know which one come out, which one is there, which one hold it, which one hold it. Just check, okay?
In that case, for it to focus on a particular object, wouldn't it have to make contact with the object? The mind and the mental object, wouldn't it have to make contact for it to then focus on a particular aspect of it?
The person is illegible. You keep a chance to go off.
In that situation, it would seem like contact would have to come before intention.
Uh-huh.
Only in that, but yeah, intention seems like it would always be first.
Yeah, could be.
Could be, okay.
Could be. Could it doesn't be. Mean I agree.
Okay. Not yet.
I was just thinking, you know, while I was listening to you, talk, I heard a car go by.
Yeah.
But I heard it, but I wasn't intending to listen. It wasn't my intent to listen to it. So maybe all this, and I'm just exploring, I don't know that I'm right, but maybe all this is from the perspective of karma. So because the intention is what's creating the karma, is that not correct? So like, so the aspect of like me hearing the car go by was an incomplete action, or maybe a side action or a side process, because there was no intentionality involved in it. Do you follow what I'm saying?
No, I'm not sure. You mean intention or attention?
Intention, not attention. So I mean, I'm listening to you. I'm my intent is listening.
Yes.
But I hear a car go by.
Yeah.
So that intruded on my attention a little bit.
Yes.
Or maybe a lot. It'll probably be a lot.
So there
right?
was attention.
But there was attention. But there was no intention. So it was not. It's not like recorded on the karmic scale.
So your mind heard the sound, right?
It did hear it,
so
but unintended. But
your mind
no
engaged in that object,
just
right? Your mind engaged in that object.
Yeah. Of course, because
yes,
that's
so
why
that is
the
intention.
Yeah.
That's the intention.
It's the moving of the mind.
So you have to look in the text and see what is intention.
Yeah.
So that is the intention. Your
it's
mind engaged into that object, right?
It's such a desire to you.
So it's unintentional intention.
Yeah. It's the difference between the English language and the way they're using it in this.
Oh, okay.
It's
okay.
Accidental intention.
Sembase,
it's
your mind that's the intention, the opening.
Sembase, the sambase, right?
Depends
how you define it, right?
Mm.
So in the scripture, what is intention there? It's like if your mind is engages in that, that's intention. If your mind engages in that object, then it's intention. If you didn't engage in that, you would not even hear it, right?
Mm.
You know, you heard it, that means your mind engages, engaged into that object. So that is intention.
So then it's involuntary intention.
Yeah.
Okay.
Involuntary intention. Yeah. Everybody thinks something, different way,
Thank you.
No, usually we think different talk together, then it's more you understand.
Yeah.
Mm.
Also more simple. Otherwise I say wah.
Mm.
Oh yes, you guys just listen them. cross the book, they go back, they all forgot.
Yes.
And you say something over here, then the word you step on. Okay, please.
What is the difference between the five omnipresent mental factors and the five object ascertaining mental factors? The five object ascertaining mental factors seem to be more subtle and sort of internal, almost like they're factors that are almost specifically geared towards the realization of Dharma, whereas the other ones seem to be more sort of this worldly. Maybe I'm completely mistaken, but.
Mm-hmm. 유명한 권능가의 결과 그래서 뭐라서는 또 유명한 이들에 대해서 먼저 추어나 터버지 그것도 냠냠도 터버지 아니 권능가 세대 먼저 다가서 직접 받아 터버스 그래서 처음에 나
대도 이제 말해줘 봐 내 다 시켰던 거 다 시백이 얘는 유당시에 시작해서 봐 아니 권능가 세 시바 관계가 냠냠도 권능가지 이게 아직도 다 이게 그 시바디가 얘들 또 막 시박 두둥강을 먹어야지 영향이 나왔어. 그 자신 없대서. 그 개미게 개장판이 되고 말대. 차서 막 먹고 그랬어.
또 유진배 차례야.
유진배 차례.
유진배 차례.
영향이 나왔어. 시박 관계 고등학교에서 그런 거 나왔어.
So the, well, you know, the, it could be that the way you said it, and it could be also, it's also something that, you know, that is there. In the, whether it's in the worldly or in the spiritual, it's always there in our day-to-day life, you know. So anyway, so how it is defined in the text is the omnipresent, which means always there, right?
Mm-hmm.
So which is always there in every primary mind, in the surroundings of every primary mind, so in the retinue of the primary mind. Mm-hmm. It's always there. So if there is a primary mind, then this omnipresent mental factor has to be there all the time there. And so this the five object ascertaining mental factors are in terms of apprehending the object. You know, so if you look at another discussion, you know, it says since these mental factors hold object through apprehending the individual features of the object, they are said to be individually ascertained objects. And so if any of these are missing, then the main mind will not be able to perform its function towards its object. So it's not really to do with the, you know, the practice, dharma practice, or the worldly thought and things like that, but you know, you can also think it that way.
No, it's just general, how the minds work together. The main minds, they're the army, they're chief. The other guys, you know, they're helper. They're not helper others, then main guy doesn't do anything well. Mm-hmm. Or you know that, they move in the world. So isn't the
chief.
And she didn't tell you about it, okay?
Thank you.
But we think more. Then you have a question?
I was just going to say that I think that it says in the text the object ascertaining mental factors are neither virtuous nor non-virtuous, but it just so happens that the examples they're giving happen to be a lot of the virtuous ones because they're geared towards dharma practice. At least that's how I understand it. And I wanted to clarify something with Geshe-la. So the omnipresent mental factors are by definition always there. The object ascertaining ones, from what I understand, sometimes these arise, sometimes they don't. For instance, mental stabilization for me doesn't arise very often. So when you say that every person, you know, if we don't have these object ascertaining mental factors, we won't be able to function well, it doesn't mean that they're not omnipresent, they're not always there for every object that we see. Is that correct?
The Yunnan Tapas Yogura, the Tapas, Sosan Kot Yogura, in a Yunnan Kasa, Kunduma Yogur, the Yunnan Yogur Maras. The Tarangas and other Tarangas and other Yunnan never in a charge at Thomas Yudus. The Penacoranga Yunnan and the Penacoran Sambush, good medicine with Hassan Yunnan and Penacoranga, thing is in the Korea would mess. Other loads, because you chill. So yeah, of course, you know, the mental stabilization or you know, meditative stabilization, there are different levels, right? So you are able to do something, you know, by focusing on it, so that is mental you know, stabilization. So it is not like maybe you are not able to meditate on a single object, you know, for 5-6 hours, but you can maybe meditate on it for a few seconds, right? That is some kind of meditative stabilization also. So it's different levels, of course. So and also you know in your daily work, you know, the job that you do, you know, you have to have some kind of focus, right? You do that. So that's also meditative civilization. So the single pointed mind. So that's like you're focusing on your work or whatever you're doing, eating, drinking, whatever. So you're focusing, you know, for a certain amount of time, certain duration of time. That's you know, single pointed mind. So here you're paying attention, you know, to or focusing on the job or you know things that you do in your day-to-day life. But then, of course, you know, you can focus on more on the virtuous things, you know, like on the emptiness or compassion and so forth. So then that will become more virtuous.
Okay.
So all of these, you know, when we go to sleep, all of these go to sleep also.
Right.
So we don't ascertain anything, right, at the time when we go to sleep. Yeah, so when you meet with the condition, then they are, you know, they're ready to be ready to arise, right?
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Another one, if it's okay.
Yeah.
This is going back to valid versus invalid minds. You were saying that a valid mind has to be fresh, it has to be something new. Versus the next time I see Keshela, I've already met him and so on, so it would be, is that correct when you'd say it's an invalid mind if it's not saying something new?
Mm-hmm.
It's an ideal mind, is what he's talking about, not valid cognition. The freshness cognition describes ideal mind. Mm-hmm. Is that correct?
Ideal mind.
Is that right?
We were talking about valid versus mistaken minds.
Invalid mind, right?
Invalid
is not necessarily mistaken.
Right.
It's
Sorry.
Just not new.
But one of the conditions for a valid mind is that it's something new.
That's right. Yeah.
So would it be fair to say that if you're seeing something again, it's not new and fresh, that it's invalid?
Invalid, yes.
Okay.
So if you are seeing something that you have already seen before, then it's not valid mind.
Okay.
But if you are seeing something that you haven't seen before, like even if you're seeing the same person, but if you see something different in that person,
mm-hmm.
which you haven't seen before, you are seeing this for the first time, then it'll be a valid mind.
Okay.
Right? Yeah. But if you are seeing the same thing which you have seen before, you're seeing which you have seen before, then it's not valid mind. So it has to be something that you haven't seen before, you have seen for the first time. So you're not seeing something new, you are seeing what you have seen already before, so therefore it's not valid mind. So that will be a subsequent realizer, a subsequent cognizer. So you're cognizing it again subsequently, you know? So that's subsequent cognizer. And that is not a, I mean, of course, you know, it depends how you define it, right? So in the definition, it has to be new, infallible, and, you know, cognizing. And so if it is not new, then it's not valid.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, but later you see Geshe-la, you know, coming back from vacation, right? A little bit tame, which you haven't seen before, right? That aspect you haven't seen before. Right? And you see for the first time, so that would be a valid mind.
Then you next to you,
I was just going by the Geshe Rabten book.
Yeah.
He describes that as ideal mind. He uses the phrase ideal as opposed to valid or invalid. That it's the most beneficial mind, something new. The three qualities we talked about. So I was just wondering if it's just the same name, if you're using
I think
valid,
it's the same thing, yeah.
As
it's a valid mind.
Okay.
So, you know, they're using the different word for valid mind, maybe saying that ideal mind.
Yeah.
You know, and valid mind, I think, are the same.
Valid mind, instead of, as opposed to, see, I'm getting confused with valid mind and valid cognition.
Yes.
That would be different. Valid mind and valid cognition are different phrases. I might assume that.
Well,
there's,
you know,
synonyms in this case.
In this case, it would be same, valid cognition and valid mind. So the mind, you know, is cognizing, you know, which cognizes is a mind. What cognizes is a mind. So cognition and the mind here are the same.
Probably, if you were to be more technical, you'd have to stick with valid cognition. Having just in general talking like this, they've been saying valid mind, but they've been using it synonymously. But if you were to get into debate and be technical, you wouldn't be able to say, I think there would be a difference between some mind versus cognition. Just that in this context, we're using a synonymous term.
Okay, I get that. Thank you. Thank
you. Okay, now we stop. Thank you very much. No more campus. No more confused.
More confused.
Yeah. If you talk more, then more confused.
Thanksgiving.
First, you know, when you talk, it will make sense. Then we talk more, then they all more difficult, more broken. Thank you. Thank you, Chanting Master.
Thanksgiving.